Party, Fixxxer here, and welcome back to Kona. We are ready to move onward into the northern parts of the area. My snowmobile has magically teleported there because I have since closed out the game and started it back up. And the snowmobile and the truck seems to reset whenever you do that. But anyways, I believe I've got everything I need here. I took a picture of that arrow, and I'm ready to go. Let's check my map one more time. See, there's a trail, and really not far ahead is another tower. Should be able to see it from here, but it's a little dark. Yeah, let me get on that there, Chief. Usually it takes a moment to kick the light on as well. See, it's not on. It should kick on any minute now. There we go. I don't know why it does that. Which way is the trail? Is it this way? Yeah.
Carl had found what he was looking for. He needed to get back on the road.
But I feel like the Firewatch Tower is this way. Oh, that looks like large ground. It is not that way. Maybe ahead a little bit more then? Want to be careful here. Something up ahead. Oh, it's the Firewatch Tower. Observation Tower. Wonderful. Alright. Goody gumdrops. What we got here? A hands-free flashlight? Oh! Good idea, developers. Good idea. Alright, let's go in here first. I should have been more careful. There could have been a guy standing there with a shotgun, right?
Carl reckoned that the place was still inhabited less than 24 hours ago. His detective sense tingled, revealing to him, or was it the strong smell of wilderness in the air, that there were most likely two men.
Really? We got a little bit of Brokeback Mountain going on in here. Letter for Pierre, Tuesday, March 15th. I just want to remind you that there are rules. Rules that are meant to be followed, whether you like it or not. I hear that you've been poaching a lot lately, that you don't even care about being discreet anymore. Heck, I don't even have a chance to pretend I don't see you these days. If I continue to turn a blind eye on this, what will people say? You've gone too far this time, buddy. I'll have to find you, Wilfred. Okay, so Pierre is a poacher. There is a cigarette down there.
The jacket was still soaking wet. The poor man had, surely unwillingly, had a taste of the pond's water not too long ago. According to the pay stub, that poor man was Alexandre Blais.
Blais. I gotta remember that.
Two blankets. There were doubtless two people here, Carl reckoned.
Fire. I think I'm warm. Maybe...
Two blankets.
Yeah, I didn't want to do that.
There were doubtless two people here, Carl reckoned.
Anything else interesting? Is there wood out here? Maybe... I mean, I've... Oh, that's right. It opens inward. Oh, that's not wood. That sure is. Alright, let's do this just for the sake of our sanity. I guess I did hit that. I was wondering what that noise was. Alright, my sanity is getting kind of low too. So let's light them up. See? Oh, there it is. See? It just burns. He doesn't care. Carl doesn't care. There's really nothing much in here.
There should be a rifle hanging there. Its owner may not be very far.
What's that?
The door was unlocked. Carl felt kind of disappointed that he wouldn't have to solve the mystery of that padlock.
Alright, let's go up in the tower then. Hopefully no wendigos. Oh, there's not a whole lot up here, just a chest? Alright. And a flag. Whoa! I almost jumped right off. Alright, let's take a look around the back. Is there more firewood here? Can I... Inventory's full. Alright, can I put that in here? Wood. How much can I carry? I feel like... Oh! I passed right by this thing. Beer bottle. Okay, well, the beer bottle just made my inventory full. Anything I can dump off in here? Anything at all? The guns are kind of heavy, but... I don't know, man. I don't have a whole lot here. I got a lot of flares. I don't know if I need them all. I'll keep the steak just in case. I don't really need the beer bottle, do I? Fire starter. I hear something. I think that's generic sounds. I don't... See, I'm worried to get rid of stuff like the hatchet and the hammer. You never know when it's going to come up. Wait, how much wood did I have anyway? I have 9. I'm okay. What am I doing? Alright, what do we got here? We got footprints. Alright, let's go, Carl. We got work to do. Probably should have checked my map first, but whatever. I have a feeling it's going to be fairly linear from here. Whoa! Stop! Stop the vehicle, Carl. What is that? A hatchet here. Is this of any importance? It gives me the option to throw it away, so probably not. Northern forests. Whoa, 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 whoa! Is that just a I think that's a trail marker. All right, I don't think those are important. At least I hope not. Oh, Jesus! There's a spirit dog! What? What was that? That's not normal! Am I supposed to be getting chased right now? What the shit? Oh, I thought I could do that. I guess not. Sorry, spirit dog. I don't want anything to do with you, to be honest. Carl is less accurate and runs shorter distance. He's a little stressed than me. Is this supposed to be, like, you gotta leave your snowmobile behind? Alright, hold on. First of all, let's do this since he's stressed. I mean, after seeing that, I suppose I would be stressed as well. Okay. That's litter. There you go. Good job, Carl. Oh wow, it got put out in the water. That was pretty neat. Where am I at? Oh wow, I'm all the way up here. I have a feeling I am supposed to leave my snowmobile behind. Maybe over there? Whoa, 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 let's get warm.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Alright, let's grab me a log. Right here. Oh, nice. I guess I can grab that, too. Or maybe not. Okay, never mind, then. How am I? Consumable. Let's have another one. Okay. And I'm gonna grab some more of those painkillers. Grab one of those. I have one log on me, right? I don't think I need any of these. Gas can, probably not. All right. So let us consume a painkiller. Because it feels like, actually, the snow is, like, hurting me. So maybe I'll grab all of them. Do I need any of this? A second log would be nice, right? Do I have a second log? Oh, just the one? Oh boy, what do I gotta give up then? Actually, looks like the med kit takes up a lot of weight. These don't take much at all. The pliers? It shows you right down here in case you're not sure. These take up like nothing. So basically it's the med kit, the log, and the gun right here. The Lee Enfield is what's taking up all my weight, I would think. I'm full. I would definitely like to take a second log with me. Can I squeeze out matches? How many of these can I take? Are these like waitlist? I have a feeling these are waitlist. I mean, look how many I'm taking. Oh, shit, I didn't mean to do that. I don't need empty bottles. Where, did I grab it? No? I'll take the fire starters. And the rest, I think I'm done with. Alright. I heard that. Alright, we're gonna try crossing, but I have a feeling that we gotta walk it. Go that way. It won't let me go in there. That's very, very strange. Okay, let's go down then. Let's see if there's any kind of crossing I can use. Not there. Oh, can I build a bridge? Oh yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Cool, I'm so glad. Alright, what do you gotta say about this, Carl? Just wondering if that would injure me. Where am I? Which way am I facing? Alright, there's a cabin to the left. Wait! That's not on here. Okay, put the map down. Grab your flashlight. There you go. Okay.
The door had been busted down violently. And a burnt smell filled the air. Half of the cabin had been consumed by flames. Carl surveyed the chaotic scene, noticing that someone appeared to have intended to use the furniture as bonfire fuel. Carl had no idea how such a mess could have occurred, but he knew it didn't bode well.
Well, they're packing it on. Why do I need all this stuff? First aid kit? Alright, well there's really nothing in here. We got that. But I'm pretty sure this key that I have is going to be needed up ahead. I saw something over there. And that looks like a path right there, too, doesn't it? There are paths all over the place. Oh, boy. Alright, well, there's something here. There's a cabin. Alright, so that's the last arrow, which we've kind of expected, right?
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Thought I could touch it. Alright, key picture. The hunt. I got an achievement for that.
Seems like this place was long deserted.
Come on, I want to start a fire. Why won't it? It's like only in a certain spot. Really weird. Alright, how's my sanity? Alright, I tried to reach there, but I guess not. Alright, any goodies? Just besides the radio. Ammo? That's telling for times that are coming.
Just one more move for Black to checkmate White.
Yeah, I guess so. Alright. That's it? There's nothing else in here? Did that use up my key? Inventory. Yeah, I got no more keys, so basically that key is just to provide me with a place to warm up and maybe a few extra supplies, I suppose. I would like a piece of wood to replace the one that I just used. Anything interesting back here? A trough? With flowing water? And a bar of soap? How come the water's not frozen? What's that? An onion and potatoes? Wood. Alright. Actually, I should have looked at my map. The animation is just a little too long for my taste. Where are we? Alright, so we just can follow this. Just make sure I'm sticking to the north. Alright. Easier said than done when you don't have a compass in front of you, actually. I should hit a path if I go straight here, and then we make a left. How about we just do that? Should hit a path. I can't. Okay. And then I go to the left, I guess? Is this the left? I was just gonna say, I was about to say I'm waiting. Oh! Spirit dog. Spirit dog, you got rid of my snowmobile. No, I gave it the office. I gave it the office. It's not a very effective spirit dog. Hold on. I don't know which way I'm supposed to go, actually. Is he still there? Alright, hold on. Slow down, spirit dog. Can I hurt you? Alright. He's gone. How am I, though? My sanity is still horrible. Alright. Are there any drugs I can do besides cigarettes? Let's have another. This is teaching kids horrible things, developers. Horrible things. I'm gonna open that. How come it won't let me? There we go. Can I just do this then? I hear that. Alright, let's look at the map. Where am I? Alright, so I gotta go that way. Where the road is all blocked off. How am I? I'm a little injured. Painkillers. Okay. Which I can't do, obviously. Alright. So instead, we have to go down. And basically, I have to make a left. I don't think I need to follow the... Well, I might have to follow the trail because it looks like there's a wall there. Alright, that's concerning. There's another one over there, but the goodies are up this way. I don't feel like I need to go down there. Probably. Oh, loading screen. big loading screen. Oh. What the shit is that? What is that? Hold on a second. I'm a little concerned. Are those just crystals? I think those are just crystals. Nope, those are frozen people. All right. Hello, fellas.
Two more victims of this ice plague. Carl felt a chill down his spine. What if he was next?
Don't worry, Carl. All right, Carl. Lee Enfield time. This guy had glasses. I should probably be able to identify him from the pictures I saw. But I don't remember what people looked like. What is that noise? Do you hear that? Yeah, this guy looks concerned. I wonder if I could grab that gun. It doesn't look like I can. Alright. Oh shit. There's something up there, guys. But this is obviously a place that I have to leave my vehicle. Where are we at? Alright. I hate that the gun is not on a hotkey. Right, I thought there was something there. So there's some sort of sanctuary up here. Okay.
Carl felt the strong pull of a vision overcome him.
What the shit? This looks like I'm gonna learn a word, a thum. Well then, is this a Wendigo? This looks like a Wendigo to me. Holy cow. And it looks like he's got an arrow in his chest. Hold on. I want to see the hunt. What did it leave off on? That's it. And a cabin in the middle of the forest.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Okay, okay. Yeah, keep that one. Hide it so people can find it. Oh boy, Carl. Hopefully this warms you up, Carl. Carl, I didn't want you to do that. I didn't want you to do that either. This can't be good, Carl.
A young woman.
That's a little terrifying. Hello?
It looked like a simple hunting accident. There was Hamilton. Carl recognized him.
He looks white to me. I don't know how you can recognize him. So did Hamilton accidentally shoot someone? Or someone else shot him and Or was this the blackmail?
A major hunting accident.
This has got to be the blackmail then, right? Hamilton shot him, and that's what... Was it Pierre that was blackmailing him? Holy cow, I don't know why, I can't remember. So she was brought here to get healed.
The doctor examined the young woman.
Yeah. Thank you. This is very Ethan Carter-esque, isn't it?
But death couldn't be overturned.
I'm a little cold. Can you hurry it up, Doc?
She was dead.
Alright, what do I do? You're leaving me here, game. Okay?
It was not the type of body you buried in a big ceremony in the village graveyard.
No, you buried it out by Lamont's. So what, the
it
whole-
It had to be hidden. No one could know about this.
Why?
The best way to do that was to have a simple-minded man bury the poor girl. Lamotte, the mechanic.
What? Why would you do that if he wasn't there and didn't know about it? Or was he there? Maybe he was there. Uh-oh. Wait, is that the doctor?
The doctor denied the unfair death of the young woman. But Hamilton had him in his grips. Hamilton knew all of the poet's secrets and wouldn't hesitate to reveal them. I know all about your crimes, you little communist. You know mine. What a sordid affair.
All right, so the doctor killed him. Okay. Interesting that a doctor would turn to that.
Carl understood the ins and outs of the affair. A woman had been killed in an unfair accident, and a young warrior had damned himself to avenge her.
A young warrior? So, where am I going with this? Am I supposed to touch this? Okay.
But Hamilton, the one responsible, had already been killed, and so the beast could not quench his thirst for vengeance. And now, recklessly, Carl had pulled the bolt from the beast's heart.
Uh-oh.
A beast who was but a young free man lost without his fiancée.
Oh!
Had, out of hatred, become Wendigo.
I've got evidence, you little shit! I've got evidence! Hold on. Get my Lee Enfield. I don't want to shoot him. Oh boy. Let's not shoot him unless I have to. Hello, spirit dog. Gotcha. Alright, he's not terribly fast. But I shouldn't say that because I'll jinx myself. So they killed the Cree woman. And the man, in his rage, went Wendigo. No! I hope I have no bullets. Shit! Oh no! What is my health like? Hold on. Consumable. Oh my god, my sanity is pretty low, and that's quite understandable, I would think. Run, 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 you fool. Fly. What else we got? I thought that would help with my sanity. Okay. Oh no, which way do I go? Let's go this way. Let's not go this way. How many bullets do I have left? Nope! What are you doing, gun? Okay, I got a little space between him and I. Why is he getting revenge on me? Or is that kind of the point of the Wendigo? They just want to kill the anybody. Okay, it's hurting me this way now. I mean, he could really just put those in front of me, right? I mean, come on. Hold on. How is my sanity still bad? Can I have a smoke while I'm running? I sure can. Shit. That means. Oh no, he sounds really close. I got two bullets left. Oh! No! I'm at the cemetery. Oh, I had more bullets, I guess? I thought I had two. So, okay, this looks bad. I don't want to end at the cemetery. Oh, whatever. I really don't want to kill the guy. Am I supposed to kill the guy? Oh, he's running after me now. What am I supposed to do? Do I really have to kill him? I really don't want to. Oh, shit. Alright, I didn't see this spot. Hold on, what else do I have? I still need... painkiller. Consumable painkiller. Consumable painkiller. Run. Go, 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 go! What? What? This is bullshit! This is some Outlast bullshit!
The narrow passage sheltered him, but for how long?
I don't know. Hold on a second here. Thank you. Oh, run! Run! Keep it! And grab your weapon. I really, really hope I'm not supposed to be killing that guy. Because I don't want to. But this feels like I'm supposed to be pumping a bunch of bullets into him as I run away. He does not sound happy. Alright. Alright. So, consumable. Let's grab one of these. Alright, my sanity is pretty good now. We had how many cigarettes running from this guy? Oh shit. Oh! This looks very familiar. Hello, can I get through here? No? Can I get through here? Why? It won't let me run. It's very cold. Is there a way in? Oh, come on. Are you serious right now? I can't pull that. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? There's probably a way to clip these or what? Was this the right way to go? Was I right the first time? Crouch. No? Yeah, I didn't think so. So, wait a minute. What am I supposed to do here? I'm glad Mr. Man is giving me time. Okay. Is this it right here? Oh, for the love of God. Don't yell at me. What's that noise? Is that him coming? It sure is. Okay, any supplies in here? Telephone? Nothing? Bueller? Oh, Jesus Christ! I did not expect him to get here that quickly. Ooh. Look at that. He just drained all the heat from me. Well, I really, really did not expect him to run up on me that quickly. How far is my checkpoint? The cemetery? Really? That's a long ways away, isn't it? Let's see where it puts me. If it's like right at the cemetery or after the cemetery, I don't know.
The narrow passage.
Where's my light?
Him, but for how long?
And where is? Oh, he's gone. All right, where's my light? There we go. So I hear that. How are my consumables? Oh my God! It doesn't reset my consumables? Or did... I don't know. Painkiller. Equipment. I've got... Did it say I have -4 bullets? It would be nice if it showed on screen how many bullets I truly have. Okay. This could be a major problem if I'm supposed to kill this guy. I have a feeling that you don't, though. But if I was supposed to use all those bullets on him... That might mean I've screwed up and I might have to reload an older save. But I guess we'll find out soon enough. And really, If you guys are hearing this, it's probably not edited out, which means everything will be okay. I'll be fine. Alright. What is that over there? Is that like a town? Alright. Yeah, he's not a happy camper. Am I supposed to take the boat? Run! Carl, run! I just got multiple achievements. He can't swim! He's like Samwise! Am I controlling this bolt in any way? I am not.
When he disappeared, so did Purity. I would defend Purity against the winds, the tides, against ice and blizzard.
Okay.
Could it be that all this was but a story of justice and vengeance? The soulful doctor, avenging his fiancée's unjust death by avenging this young woman as though she was his lover. Are these passionate feelings not precisely the kind of feelings that could cause a storm, petrify people deep inside, create monsters?
Alright, I'll wait till after the credits to talk about the game. Oh shit! Game is not over! Game's not over. That Wendigo is gonna pop right. Oh! Does the Wendigo have a boat? Who are these guys? Don't trust them, Carl. I do not have control over this boat. I just.
Un survivant! On a trouvé un survivant!
Oh! Okay. Carl was fine. He lived happily ever after. Case solved. Alright, so it appears to me that Dr. Beaupré, remember his wife was killed, right? At the very beginning of the game, there was the car. We found the other car, and it had a picture of him and his wife in it, and he ran off or whatever happened. I don't know. So he thinks Hamilton killed his wife, or Hamilton did kill his wife. I don't know. And then Hamilton killed this Cree woman in a hunting accident. And so this, what, pushed Dr. Beaupré over the edge? And he just, like, just came so full of rage from all the shit that Hamilton has done? And is like, I'm just going to F you up and F everybody else up. I'm not sure I get that. I mean, I can see him. Was it him murdering? Okay, alright, I guess I get it then. So, he murdered Hamilton in retaliation for the Cree woman, and I'm guessing his wife. I'm guessing he blames Hamilton for his wife's murder. Judging by what we know about Hamilton, he probably did it, right? We don't need any evidence. But I'm guessing Hamilton killed his wife, then the Cree woman. So he kills Hamilton. Was it the killing of Hamilton that then turned him into a Wendigo? I think that's what happened. So the killing of Hamilton pushed him over the edge, turned him into Wendigo, and you don't... I'm guessing you don't have the same thought process in mind when you're a Wendigo, right? At that point, some kind of... I don't know, something else takes over you, and then he went around and attacked the town. That's what I'm guessing what happened. So this basically all happened within, like, a two-day span, you know? I don't know why, because the game did mention, you know, oh, there's, they've, every time you walk somewhere, oh, it feels like they just left. But for whatever reason, what I saw made me feel like that this was, took place over a little bit of time, I guess. But in the end, I think this happened over like a 1 or 2 day span, and that's about it. I don't know when Dr. Beaupré's wife was first killed. Was that also just a couple days ago? Did this thing all happen like that? All snowballed into one huge cluster and is that what happened? I have a feeling that's what happened. Because I got the impression that Dr. Beaupré's wife died a little while earlier, but I think I was wrong about that. I know I've missed a few documents here and there, I'm sure, but I think I got the gist of the story. I'm good with it. The ending kind of came quite suddenly, right? Once we tore down that wall, I knew it was going to be short, but that was basically like one episode, right? I don't know how long this episode ended up being. It's a little long. I was going to cut it into two, but I'll just plop it out into one episode. But I enjoyed the atmosphere of this game. I thought it was quite immersive. They did a really good job making me feel like I'm in the harsh, cold winter of Quebec, you know? It made me feel like I was there. It was quite immersive. I really liked it. There you go. There you have it. That was Kona. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next series. Bye-bye.